Hey guys, we're back with another Revit tutorial. Today it's Big Architects again, so Bjark Ingels or BIG. We are doing Vancouver House. No points for guessing which city that's in. Vancouver, Canada, of course. It's a really cool tower. It's about 150 meters tall and I think about 49 levels from memory. And what's really cool about it is that it transforms or it blends from basically a triangular or almost perfectly triangular floor plate at the ground floor up until a rectangle on the upper floors. And that's because of the context. You can see there's like these highways and infrastructure and on the ground floor, on the lower levels, and these, you know, setback requirements. But then there's a bit more flexibility on the upper levels. And obviously this is a pretty amazing architecture, but also structurally quite impressive. And there's also just more floor space than it would have been if it was just triangular the whole way up. So really cool building. We're going to be looking at in-place massing today. We're going to show you two different methods. Really importantly, I'm going to show you two different methods to create this building. Both ways are perfectly fine. Not sure which you can take your pick, whichever one is your own preference. There's no real right or wrong. Both ways work. Both ways have slight advantages and slight disadvantages, or limitations rather, but they are both perfectly valid. They're both really useful in different use cases. But that's pretty much it. If you want to like, subscribe, comment, share, sure, go for it. If not, still please enjoy the video. I hope you like it. I hope you learn something from it and find it interesting. But without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is set up our levels, regardless of which method we're going to choose. So to do that, we know the building is 150 meters total in height, and there are 49 levels. So we can do that really quickly with an array. So if we select this level here, we come up to array, we tell it that we want 48. So this includes, the number you put in here includes the one that you have selected. So we've got level one down here, and we want an additional 48 levels. And then we want to go to the last one here like that. And then if we select here and move up, because we've already got 4 meters between level one and level two, we can just type 146 meters, hit enter. And don't worry about the naming of the levels, it's not really relevant for this tutorial. But we come to the top, and the important thing is that this top level here is at 150 meters. And we can just call it roof to make it a little clearer. Alright, so levels are done. Next, we want to set up our elevations. So here we've got east, north, south, west elevation. Doesn't really mean much to us now. So we're going to change these names to the long and the short sides, and whether it's the curved or the flat. So just to show you what I mean, using this south elevation, I'm going to drag in the elevation, one of the elevations that we have, like that. So you can see this is the longer face or facade, and it's the curved facade. You can barely see it there, but you can see it's a bit darker and it gets lighter. So this is the side that curves. And we want to move that, select this, and move it to here. So I'm assuming that the ground is about there. If it's a bit, I can even nudge that up, maybe there like that. So that's roughly where the lowest level is, or the street level for this building. Then we want to resize it. So come up here to scale, pick that low, the lowest level, come up here. Make sure your cursor is moving vertically and it's snapping vertically like that, and then pick the top of this building like that, of the image, and then zoom in to the top here to the roof level, and just make sure you snap that there. It'll drag that up there. While we're here, I'm actually going to just, with my keyboard, just holding down shift and nudging to the left, just get this out of the way so that our levels aren't blocking the rest of the building. Cool, so we have that there. Now let's call this here, let's right click, rename, and let's call it long elevation curved side, which means that the north is also a long elevation, but it's the flat side. And then we have, this is the south on the right here, which would make that the east, would be the curved. So right click, rename, short elevation curved side, and the west would be the last one, which needs to be short elevation flat side. Cool, and that'll make a bit more sense in a minute, but that just helps us organize our file a little bit. So now we can go to the other curved side, because the short elevation curved side, which is this side around here, double click that. And now I'm going to drag in the only other elevation that we had, which is this one, and it's actually a photo. And that is okay, because for the purposes of this tutorial, and often you don't have accurate, precise, you know, dimension drawings to always work off, we sometimes need to improvise. So first thing is move, pick the ground floor here, and just move that down to that level. Then let's scale it. Scale, come down here, pick this level, and come up again, and let's pick the top there of the image, and then zoom out and zoom into here to the roof, and make sure we click and snap to there. So now this elevation is also correct, and I'm just going to nudge this out a little also, so we'll draw the building a little to the side. Next thing is to add our reference planes. So architecture, reference plane. And we just want to draw a plane on the edge of the building here, another one on the edge there, and then let's give these some names. So select this one, so this is the flat side, so long flat, I'm just going to call it, and this one I'm going to call it short, this will be long curved. And then if we go to our other curved elevation, architecture, reference plane, and draw this line down here. And you can probably nudge that across a little bit like that. And another one, architecture, reference plane, and draw one on this side like that. And I can just nudge it again with my keyboard to get it in the approximately right spot. You need to give the reference planes a name whenever you want to draw on them. So we're going to select this, click, and I think it's just good practice to always give your reference planes a name when you don't have too many, or even when you do have too many. I think it's if you're going to be using them, it does sometimes just help to name them in the first place, and makes it a lot easier to refer to them. So we're going to call this one flat. So this was the short flat. And this one here we'll call it, this is the short and curved side. So now we want to go to back to the short elevation curved side, and we can do pretty much the rest of it from here. So if we go architecture, massing and site, in place mass, okay, and come up to the rectangle, and then specify a new work plane, pick the name, and come down here and select reference plane, and we're going to draw the back first, which is the short flat. Okay, and then make sure rectangle's on, make sure that draw on work plane is on, and we can go from here. You notice, by the way, that up here it's snapping to that level 50. It's snapping to that there, so that's really important. So there, and then all the way down, and make sure that it's snapping to the lowest level and the reference plane there at that intersection. Perfect. So that's done. And then we can do another, we can do line now, and choose reference plane short curved. So we're going to draw this front curve now. And there's a few ways to do this. You can start pretty much anywhere, but let's just start here, come across with a straight line, change to our spline, and just add a few points in here. So I'm going to go with this line here, about there, and then finish up down here like that, and then bring it back to a line. Pick this point and then close it off up there. Hit escape, and we're just going to go to 3D view for a moment just to see exactly what we have done. All right, so all we've done is drawn basically two shapes. One is on the back short flat side, and the other is on the front, which is the short curved side. And then we select both of these like that, select the whole thing like that, and create form, solid form, and there you have it. So that's the first way. It's a good way. The limitation of this way is that you aren't able to control your floors that closely. All right. If I just control Z for a second before we created that form as well, it's probably worth going into this elevation, and you can also tweak this. So if you tab to select this spline like that, you can see these points here. You can actually drag this in and out to get that a bit more accurate based on whatever reference images you're using. Maybe something there like that. And this one here, we can probably pull this in a little bit there as well. That seems about right. Maybe a little more even. Cool. Like that. Let's go back to the 3D. Select those, create form, and there you go. All right, so now I'm going to show you the second method as well. So we're going to try and do that a little quicker. But I'm going to show you because that might be useful as well in some cases where you don't have an elevation, for example, or in cases where you want to more accurately model your floor plates. So to do that, we need to go to a floor plan now. So let's just go to a site plan like this. And I'm actually going to, let's finish this mass and let's select it and just move it out of the way like that. So we're going to use these same reference planes again here. And if we drag these like that, just to see it a little clearer. We don't actually have to do this, but just to make it a little clearer what we're actually drawing. So these are the reference planes we drew earlier. We just go massing in sight, in place mass, okay, rectangle, and draw a rectangle there. Come to your 3D view. Hit escape, select that, go create form, and then drag this up again. You can see it there snapping to the levels. Just make sure it goes all the way to the top like that. And then if you tab to select this form again, we can now go add profile. And so what add profile does is you can see there adds profiles to a form. After adding a profile, you can select it and use it to directly manipulate the form. So to do that, click add profile. And this is useful for a couple of reasons. Here we're going to use it for two primary things. So the first is to create the shape of the curve. So we're going to add profiles to make that curve precisely how we want it, the shape that we want. But we're also going to use it to constrain our form in the upper levels to the rectangle, because the building is actually quite, it's still rectangular up the top. It doesn't, that curve doesn't start till a few levels below the roof. So to do that, I'm just going to click here, for example, add profile, again, add another profile and click there. And maybe I'll just do one more, for example, like that. If we wanted to, we could come in and modify those afterwards, but I've just got a couple of those there that will kind of constrain this in a moment, which you'll see. So now we want to do the bottom shape. So tab here till we've got that surface, select it, edit profile, then select this edge and we can drag it in. And I'm just trying to make it approximately the same size as that, to try and make these very similar so we can compare. I guess that's about right. And trim like that and hit the green tick to finish. All right, so we're almost there. You can see the obvious issue now is that this curve here is curving the wrong way. So to do that, we just need to add another profile to create that shape. So add profile, and you can drop it anywhere in here. Would work, so let's just try that. Edit profile, and then just drag this in to, you can kind of see here roughly how wide it needs to be. I'd say maybe a little bit more than that, maybe a little less than that, or something like that. trim. Kind of just eyeballing it, but that feels about right. Might need to be a little smaller, but let's just hit the green tip and see what that looks like. Okay, there we go. It's not too bad at all. It's actually really close. So finish mass. And if we go to an elevation now, like here to the right, you can see here that this, the top is rectangular here for a few more levels, whereas here with the spline, it's going all the way to the top. We could also just have added a line here with the spline, but it's actually pretty close, to be honest. And I think that's more than good enough. The last step is really just to add some floors and then add facade to this. So we're not going to add facade right now in detail. I'm going to show you how to add a wall to it. But to model the facade, you know, reasonably accurately or even remotely closely to the actual facade would take quite a bit of time. So we're going to mass the floors quickly and then throw some walls on this, and that will at least give us the complete form using Revit geometry. So again, here in the 3D model, we can select, holding down control, both of these, mass floors, select the first, come to the bottom, hold down shift, click the last, and tick that on. Okay, creates all the mass floors, and then architecture, floor by face, and you can do a window across all of these. Yeah, 150mm floor seems reasonable. Create floor, and then create walls, architecture, wall by face, and then we'll just leave it at 200 for now, but just tick all of these and orbit around and tick the back as well. And then once we're done to hide the mass, we just need to come into massing and sight, pick this little drop down and go show mass by view settings, and that should hide off all the yellow and leave us with our building, or buildings, our Vancouver houses. That's pretty much it. That brings us to the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching very much. Thank you very much for watching. If you want to see more videos like this, please make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell to get notified. If you liked it, leave a like. If you've got any comments or questions, please leave those below. And also any suggestions for future video tutorials. What do you want to see? What types of things do you want to learn in Revit or elsewhere in relation to architecture? Please leave those below or get in touch with me. Otherwise, thank you again. Have a great day, and I will see you in the next video. Cheers.